Hi everyone, welcome y'all. In the today's video, I'm going to show you one of the most important and very useful feature in Playwright, which is Trace Viewer. And the Trace Viewer is a GUI tool which will provide you the tracing, like whenever you run your test and whenever some failure is happening, so we can easily trace those failures. So normally what will happen is when you run your automation test, so something has got failed, and we will debug the code, each and every line we can debug, and where is went wrong and what is went wrong we can find out. Same thing in Playwright also, by using TraceViewer we can do it. But in TraceViewer, which is also provided some more additional stuff through which we can easily find out and we can easily debug the code, and also along with the screenshot, navigation and console log, network logs, and internally what type of API calls are executed, those API calls are successful or not. So we can get easily detailed information, okay, and by using TraceViewer. So this is one of the most important and very useful feature provided by Playwright. So this particular TraceViewer, we can automatically generate by specifying some simple configuration in the Playwright configuration file. Okay, and once the viewer file will be generated, then we can extract that particular file and then we can trace the issues. So let me show you practically how can we use this. So I'm just opening my VS Code editor, and I have an empty test tracing spec.js, and I'm just copying the test from my previous file. Let us say screenshot spec, or else record video dot spec. So I'm taking simple test and copy this test inside my tracing spec.js. It is simple login test, and this is logout too. So this will pass. Let me save the file. Okay, now this is my simple test. It will open the application, then clicking on the login link and providing the username and password, then clicking on the login link, and then it is checking the logout link is visible or not. A simple test I'm going to run. So to run the test, normally what you can do is we can just execute the test like this. Playwright npx playwright test, and the test slash tracing slash spec.js is my file name, and the project is Chromium and in the header mode, right? This is a normal way we can run. So if you want to get the trace file, right, so simple what you can do is before running the test, we need to go to playwright config.js, and in this there is a property called use, and in the previous videos we already discussed about two attribute values, screenshot and video. And apart from these two, we also have something called trace. So there are multiple options are available. You can just look at here. These are the different options are there. Trace off, trace on, and trace on all retrieves, trace on first retrieve, trace retain on failures, retrieve with the trace, and multiple options are there. So let me make it is on for now, trace on. This is one attribute I specify in this. And if you want to have screenshot and video also, you can just enable these two options. So this is a simple option which we provided in the use of in the blocker. Now save this and then go back to the test, and then I'm trying to execute. Now observe, my test is running and login is successful and everything is got passed. Fine. Now I want to see the trace file. So to see the trace file, there are multiple options are there. So if I go back to the documentation, so to view the trace, we can execute this command through command line, npx playwright show trace and a file name. But where exactly this particular file will be created? So the file will be created by default in the test results folder. If I go back to the test results, and you can see trace.zip, this is a file which is got created. So this particular file contains a all the stuff, so we can open the file in multiple ways. So one is we can directly open the file, we can trace every execution, and what we can do is we can execute this command npx playwright show trace. So I'm just executing the same command, and we need to provide the location of the trace file. So this is the file, I'm getting the relative path, and then I'm keeping it here. This is a trace file I'm trying to open with this command npx playwright show trace. So when execute this, it will automatically open the file. Now this is the most important, we need to know a lot of things in this. So let me try to show you some of the important features from this particular Playwright trace viewer. This is a UI tool, and which contains a lot of things, guys. If I look at here, there are two tabs here, actions and metadata. So what are the actions? So each and every action, whatever we have done at application, every action will be displayed in this list. So we have opened the page, we have clicked on the login link, and then we provided a username and locator, then click on the login, then finding out the logout link is present or not. So each and every step, whatever we have done through automation test, will be displayed in the actions. And apart from this, there is another tab called metadata. So in the metadata, and you can see, let me try to increase this. Yeah. Now in the metadata, you can see how much time the test is got executed on which browser and platform and user agent and viewport, like the browser size exactly shown, width and height. In mobile, no, we are not done in the mobile. We have run on the desktop or browser application, device scale, and how many pages we are interacted, how many actions are performed, how many events are performed. This is all about metadata. So which will also, we will able to capture along with the actions. These are the two important tabs which is provided. And in the bottom of the screen, you can see multiple tabs, call, console, network, source, attachments, and so on. So if I look at here, go to the network. Now I'm going to select one step now. So these are the different steps. Now I'm going to select one of the steps. Let's say I'm just trying to click on the login. I'm selecting this step. So when I select this tab, what exactly happened? So that we can see in this tabs. So call, when I go to the call tab, so you can see how, when it exactly it is called, how much time it is taken, milliseconds, and which locator we used, and all the log information also, it will display like this. And similarly, console window, currently it is an empty. And network, see here, whenever you execute this statement, how many API calls are executed internally. So all are sent, 200 means successfully done. API request is successfully done. So for every statement in our automation test, inside it will execute multiple API calls. So we can capture all this information in the network tab. And the source here, we can see exactly which statement we are currently pointing. That is a source code which we have executed. And attachments, if you have any attachments, and that will show you here. So these are the multiple options which is provided in the trace viewer. And one of the most important is, apart from all these things, we can navigate before and after each and every action. For example, there are multiple options here. You can see picker, pick locator, action, before, after. So this is the timeline. You can just see here in the top, and this is the timeline. So here it is started actually. 2.0 seconds, it is exactly started opening my browser. And when you move the timeline like this, you can see the changes are happening on the UI, right? So each and every timeline is captured here. Each and every timeline is captured here. You can see when I'm moving the cursor, the changes are happening on the UI. So this is, these are action. Suppose if you want to, for example, this is my action, right? Before this action, like I want to click on the login link. So this is one action. And before clicking on that action, what is the other action I have done before and after the login? What is another action I have done before, after? What exactly happened? That I also can check. So this is the action, and go to the before section here. So currently it is also pointing on the screenshot. You can just look at here, and whichever step I have highlighted, so that particular step is got highlighted on that exact page. Now you can see here, I'm placed my cursor on the login. I have selected this step. Now you can see, on the login button, it is giving a red ball. So this is a step, current step. And before this, before clicking on the login, what exactly happened? So that you want to see, just click on the before. When you click on the before, this is the state of the application. So this is the step is got executed. And after clicking on the login, so this is the step is got executed. So click on login. So every step, suppose before providing the password, and you can just go to before, and we provided username before passing the password. And after after providing the password, then we are clicking on the login. After providing the password, we're clicking on the login. So for every step, there is a before and after steps. So what exactly happened? So that information we can see on the before and after. And pick locator. So here also we can find the locator options. So suppose if you want to locate any elements from this, you can just inspect and it will automatically give you the locator part. So this is one more additional option which is provided in the viewer, trace viewer. Okay. And most important thing, one, this is the timeline. So each and every timeline is got recorded. This will very, very helpful while debugging the code, what went wrong, where is went wrong, all those things. Okay, this is how we can simply analyze this Playwright trace viewer. So there are multiple options are there. Let me just close this and again go back to the VS Code editor. And if I look at the configuration file, and here I just make it on every time, it will take the trace. And there are multiple options here. On off means it will not take any trace. And there are multiple options here. On all retrieves, on first retrieve, return on failure, retrieve with the trace. Okay, so these are the multiple options which are available. And the all information is provided in their documentation very clearly. So to viewing the trace from the command line, you can execute this command. And then actions we already discussed, all the actions will be captured. And metadata we already seen. Metadata means start time, duration, engine, platform, and what is the viewport on, what is the browser size, and how many pages we have interacted, actions, events, all the things will be shown in the metadata. And screenshots also will show each and every screenshot in the timeline, right? And snapshots before, action, after. So all these things will be shown in the trace viewer. And call, these are the multiple tabs, call, console, network, source. Everything is displayed. In the network, we can see what are the different API calls are happened. Source also we can see here. Okay. And multiple things are there. So if you want to record the trace on the CI environment, we can just put this option here on first retrieve. Okay. And then these are the multiple options. So on first retrieve means record a trace only when retrieving a test from the first time. And on all retrieves means record traces for all the test retrieves. Off means do not record any trace, and on means it will record the test for every test in every time. And return on failures, record a trace for each test, but remove it from successful, remove it from successful return. So that means only on the failures, this will record the trace, return on failure. So let us try to make that happen. So we can say return on failure. Let me just put this option. Now, whenever the test is failed, then only it will capture the trace. Okay, now let me intentionally fail the test. What I can do is I can just provide some incorrect locator here. So obviously my test will fail. Okay, and save this configuration, and then you can just save the file and go back and execute the run command once again. npx playwright test tracing spec.js project chromium and headed mode. Okay, now this time my test will fail. Now observe what will happen. Yes, as soon as my test is got failed, the HTML report will automatically opens here, right? You can see my HTML report is automatically opens. And in this, you can see in the bottom section, you can see traces. So this is the trace file by default attached to the report. And if you want to open the trace well in the locally, you can just go back and open this file. You can see in the test results, you can see the new latest file. And by using the command line, and you can open the file by using npx command. And if the test is got failed in the HTML report directly, the trace is got attached. If I just click on it, it will open the trace viewer. So this is running on 9323 port localhost. Same trace viewer, it is got opened. Now this time it is got failed, right? So now let us try to trace why it is failed and where exactly it is failed. And these are the steps actually. It is giving us cross mark here. You can say this is got failed. 5000 milliseconds it is waited. Expected is something and it is visible, but it has not happened. So that is the reason it is got failed. And this is a call log and time, duration, parameters, all the stuff it is showing in the call and the console. And you can see this is the error code we received. And then network, what are the different API calls are sent when you executing the statements, and the source. And this is the particular statement is got failed. And there are no attachments so far. So these are the options which is shown, and this is the timeline. So you can just navigate each and every screenshot timeline. And here you can see this is step is got failed, right? Before the failing, what happens? If I go to before, and it will show you that login screen is there. And after, this is the screen. Logout is there, but we are given some incorrect locator. So it has got failed. So before and action, after each and every action, we can see for every step. So this is very beautiful feature and very, very useful when you're automating the test in the Playwright. So this is a Playwright trace viewer, and the detailed documentation is provided. So how to use this Playwright viewer, you can just go to the documentation and try to understand these options. Okay. So that is all about trace viewer. And if you want to enable the screenshot or videos along with the trace, You can simply go to Playwright config.js and you can just enable screenshots as well as video. So all those things will be automatically captured whenever the tests are executed. So this is the most important file in which this is a block and in which we can do the configurations. And this will applicable for all the tests which are available in your project. All the tests, the same settings are applicable. Okay. So that is all about Trace Viewer. In the next video, we will see another topic. Thanks for watching.